Originally, this video was going to be a build and review for the Star Wars Death Star clock made with a free STL file. After printing this file a few more times than I planned, I realized this video needed to be about something else: getting a smooth top layer on your 3D print. After watching this video, you can still get the free STL file with the link in the description and print your own. Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Builds. I want to get this file to have a finished look without any sanding or painting, so what I'll do is I'll show you the steps that I used to get that finished look, and show you which methods work the best for a perfect top layer. Alright, so let's get started. I'm going to show you the different methods I used in 5 prints to get a smooth top layer. For the first print, I didn't make any changes when slicing the file. This file took 11 hours to complete. You can see here how visible those layer lines are. That definitely wouldn't look good on my wall. The second print was done upside down. What I did was flip the file. I wanted to see if the bottom layer looks better than the top. No other changes were made, so it also took 11 hours to print. When you look at it close up, you can still see the layer lines, but when you look at it from further back, let me adjust the focus here. It does look a lot better, especially compared to the first one. But that still isn't good enough. On to the third print. This time, I'm enabling ironing. I like using Cura, but this option should be available in any slicer that you are using. To enable ironing, you need to make sure you have the advanced options checked. Then you make sure that enable ironing is checked. Let's slice the file and then start printing. What ironing does is adds a very thin and flat top layer. This top layer prints very slowly, so the total print time is now 17 hours. Now you definitely can see a difference in the quality of the top layer. There were some areas that still didn't look good. Let me see if I can show you. Right there, you can still see some layer lines. So for my fourth try, I thought I could improve the quality by replacing the nozzle with a new one and using the same settings. Alright, now it's looking really good. Although you still can see some lines here, let me see if I can show you. You see it with light there. There are these lines that go through the entire print. Alright, so let me show you why those lines occur in the print. You can see here how there's gaps in the print, and then it comes back and fills them in later. Those gaps end up being the lines that you see in the final print. And now my fifth and final print, monotonic top layer. In addition to ironing, you need to have two other settings checked. The first is monotonic top and bottom order. And for the second, you need to open up the expert options. And you need to add monotonic ironing order. And let's go ahead and slice that. This is the top layer before ironing. You can see how it starts on one side and ends in the other. And there are much fewer areas where it has to go back and fill in the gaps. And it does the same thing on the ironing pass, going from one side to the other, because of the monotonic ironing order setting. Alright, so there's the final print. I want to say that's pretty good for coming straight off the printer. What do you guys think? Another setting I like to use is adaptive layers. It doesn't help with this file because it's just one flat area. Adaptive layers is usually if you have a lot of curves in your STL file. There might be some cases where you need to use both methods. Let me show you how adaptive layers work. This setting is more useful when you have an STL file with a lot of curves. Let me show you on this model here. So let me slice it as it is. And preview. Your print looks better when you get these yellow areas as small as possible. So let me change it to adaptive layers and slice it again. I'll switch it back and forth so you can see the difference in size of the yellow areas. And you can see here the number of total layers goes from 285 to 353. Using adaptive layers does add to your print time. For this model, it increases the print time by 23 minutes. If you like this video, please be sure to subscribe and hit that notification button, and check out this video next. Thank you for watching.